We want to talk about fish and which ones to use in your mini aquaponics system. The fish are a very critical component of this system because the feed input that goes to the fish and then their waste that they produce becomes food for the plants. So you can't have the plants without the fish, and you can't have the fish without the plants. Things that you need to consider is that each one of the fish that you could put in here has sort of an optimum range of temperature that they can grow under. So you really want to match up the plants that you're growing and their optimum temperature with the fish that you're growing and their optimum temperature. Another thing that's critically important is the fish has to eat a pelleted feed. You can put predator fish in these systems, but they need to be able to either accept a pelleted diet, or you're going to have to constantly be adding feeder fish into here, which could lead to disease problems and just not quite sustainable long term. Additionally, the nutrients that are in the feed are very important for the plants. So because we know what the nutrients are in the feed, we're able to feed our plants on a more consistent basis. The next thing you need to decide is if you're trying to grow these fish for show, ornamental type fish, or if you are trying to grow fish for food. And so there's some different ones that you could choose there. You know, for an ornamental fish species that does really well in indoor temperatures around 70 degrees Fahrenheit, you might choose a goldfish or koi or some of the smaller freshwater ornamental fish that are available, like swordtails and angelfish and guppies and things like that. Otherwise, you might choose a fish that's native to your area. And one benefit of that is if you do get tired of your system or the fish aren't growing very well and you want to get rid of them, some people have issues putting those, you know, killing the fish or whatever, so you may want to release it into a natural water body. You don't want to release non-native fish species into a water body. So it's very important to remember that. Also, if you choose to do this as more than a hobby, if you want to get into commercial scale production, you want to be able to work with a fish that is legal to grow in the area that you're at. So you may have to get an aquaculture license or an import permit or something like that. So if you are choosing to do a food fish, you want to do one that is easy to grow at the temperature that you're working at. And appropriate size for the aquarium that you're using. For example, if you're trying to do salmon, you would need really cold water, but also a salmon wouldn't fit very well into a system like this unless it's at a very small size. Trout would be another example. They like cold water, like 50 degrees Fahrenheit. You could do something like catfish. Their optimal growth temperature is around 85 degrees Fahrenheit, though, but you don't need to necessarily be at the optimum growth for the fish if you're just doing this for a hobby. Other fish species you might choose could be tilapia or barramundi or hybrid striped bass, or in our example, we're using a hybrid bluegill, which is a mixture of bluegill sunfish and green sunfish. These are very readily available where we're at from local producers, and we won't get in trouble if we put them back out into ponds. We have a couple of examples of different types of feed that you can use. There's the flake food variety, and then there's a pelleted food variety, and these come in different sizes, different nutritional contents, amounts of protein in there and whatnot, and each one of them is suited for different species of fish. So for example, this flake food is really good for things like goldfish, where this pelleted food works really good for these bluegill. And they're this smaller diameter is probably like 50% protein feed, so you're going to get more nitrogen out of this as compared to some of the other ones. And this small diameter sinks sort of slowly, and the bluegill do really well on a slow sinking diet. A good rule of thumb in aquariums is to use 1 inch of fish for every gallon of water. So we have about 7 fish in here. They're each about 4 inches long, so we could actually double the amount of fish that we have in here and still be okay in the system. Another thing to keep in mind is that each fish will perform a different function in the aquarium ecosystem. So some fish might be bottom feeders, some might eat the algae on the sides, some of them are going to be eating your fish food. So a variety of different types of fish species can actually help your tank ecosystem perform better. Now, with those considerations in mind, go out and get some fish, put them in your system after you allowed it to establish, and get going with your mini aquaponics system. Things to avoid: you might want to grow corn because it's going to get bigger than the system is. It might grow taller than your roof, but small things are really good in here, but it can grow a variety of things, and it's all up to you.